Well, first things first, we know that you shouldn't be recording wearing this jacket. What's up, guys? Hope you are doing well. And today I got a package in the mail for something that I totally forgot I had ordered. And that thing back there, whatever that thing is, technically it is a jacket and it comes from the Yeezy by Gap collaboration. And it's been long awaited and it's here. And I haven't seen many people with it yet, so I figured if I'm gonna do the first apparel review on my sneaker channel, because of course we do sneakers, then it might as well be something that just about everybody has an opinion. You really can't be neutral about that thing back there. Today we are talking about, in detail, the Yeezy by Gap round jacket in blue, the first piece ever released for this historic Yeezy by Gap collaboration. Now, before we get into it, why don't we do what we usually do and let's first take a closer look. Guys, now you've seen a closer look of that bad boy right there. I don't want to handle it too much in the video because, as you heard in the beginning, it's just going to make so much noise into the microphone with the sound and all that, and I'm not running an ASMR channel here, so we're going to leave it back there. But I've got crispy close-up video for you, don't you worry, as well as me wearing it. You can kind of see what it looks like, although we've seen what it looks like on Kanye and some other people that have had this jacket. Now, if you aren't familiar with the trajectory of how this jacket went from idea to in my basement, first, way back in 2020, Yeezy and Gap announced that they were doing a collaboration. It was gonna be this full line, it was gonna be accessible and affordable, and people went crazy. It really was a big deal because typically, Yeezy, be it the sneakers with Adidas or the Yeezy Season clothing line, have been more or less exclusive and hard to get. The Yeezy Season clothes, more because of the price point, the Yeezy's Adidas sneakers, more because of the hype, and despite how many they make, they are still hard to get. But this promised to be something more, something better, taking something that is undeniably cool in terms of Kanye West and what he does with fashion and sneakers and art and all that, and making it accessible. And I distinctly remember the Yeezus tour and the Kanye rants. I mean, I was at the Yeezus tour in Detroit, and part of the Kanye rant that he went on that stop was about making Yeezys and the things that he does and creates more accessible for everybody. He wants everyone to have Yeezys and all that. And you know, ever since that, I've kind of been like, yeah, okay, I still can't buy most Yeezys I want for a reasonable price, let alone retail, but I digress. Here we are, and these released on June 8th, 2021. June 8th, of course, is Kanye's birthday. It was his 44th birthday this year. That's when these dropped, and news broke that they had already sold out, and I thought to myself, here we go again. But it just turns out that the site had crashed, as if they didn't know they were gonna get a crazy amount of traffic. So the site gets booted back up, and then we learn that we have an additional 6 days to buy this jacket because it is a pre-order. Phenomenal. So I pre-ordered mine, and then I forgot about it because today's date is November 4th, and here we are. They finally arrived on my doorstep in a little brown box, not a medium brown box, but this thing was like folded up and like stuffed in there, and it can take it because all this jacket really is a recycled nylon and a polyfill. And we're not sure if the polyfill is recycled as well, but the nylon outer shell here is a recycled material, which is pretty dope. And it's been described a lot of ways. It's been described as a trash bag, as a deflated balloon, and those descriptions are not wrong. I think the silhouette and the structure of this jacket, what it most resembles is a bomber jacket, especially wearing it and seeing myself in the jacket and seeing some photos of Kanye in the jacket. That's what I get mostly in terms of trying to figure out what type of traditional piece of outerwear that this jacket looks like. It's definitely a bomber jacket at heart, I think, but it is a very stripped down piece of apparel in so many ways, which we're gonna get into. And ironically, this being the first piece to release, this is actually reportedly Kanye's least favorite color. Now, there's only been three. We've seen this, we saw the red one that he was wearing during the Donda listening events in Atlanta, and then we've seen a black one as well he's been wearing. And to my knowledge, the black one has not released. I don't know if the red one has either. The resale on those are definitely higher than these blue ones, so I'm assuming those have not released yet, or they've been pre-ordered, and I haven't been keeping up with it because I just bought this one and I wasn't about to buy another one because this also retails at $200. Not exactly a Gap jacket price, but definitely better than jackets and hoodies from the Yeezy Season collections, where hoodies were running like $400. Now, this isn't the only piece that has released for the Yeezy Gap collection. Last month in September, on the 29th, I believe, we saw the release for the pre-sale for all of these hoodies, what is dubbed as the perfect hoodie. It's kind of cropped at the waist and it's heavyweight cotton. I think it's double layered. And this is Kanye's interpretation of what he thinks is the perfect hoodie. And from what I can tell, this jacket was definitely polarizing. A lot of people didn't like it. Probably more people didn't like it than did like it, but the hoodies seem to have gotten better reviews. They are just hoodies after all, in solid colors. It really just comes down to fit and finish and quality, and you probably got yourself a hit. So it's easier to see why the hoodies have gone over better with the community of people that want to buy them than this thing here, because a lot of us buy clothes to kind of complement our body types. You know, make our silhouettes more svelte, make us look more fit. This jacket is not trying to help you accomplish that. This jacket is trying to make you stand out in ways that maybe some people don't want to stand out. I mean, I've been a body conscious person for a long time. I've struggled with my weight up and down. I'm doing okay right now. And honestly, this is not the type of jacket that I would look to if I was feeling really self-conscious about how I was looking that day or that time or at certain points in my life. Right now, I think I'm in a better place to rock something like this. So I guess what I'm trying to say is that depending on how you might look in this jacket or how you might perceive yourself to look in this jacket, I think it takes a little bit of confidence to pull this thing off, because it's not really doing you any favors in terms of the traditional body shapes that we find desirable, right or wrong. This is not necessarily the most flattering jacket, and I think you really have to like what is happening here and like the kind of avant-garde aesthetic and approach that this jacket takes in order to really be into it. But other than those kind of intangible, subjective things, what is really going on with this jacket? Now, like I said before, I think it's a stripped down version of a bomber jacket mostly. That's where the silhouette feels closest to me. This kind of bigger, more elongated sleeves. The collar looks like an exaggerated collar you would see on a bomber. And then the kind of just shape it takes when it's on my body makes me think that. But this thing doesn't offer much in functionality in terms of zippers, buttons, and closures. This thing has nothing. There are no zippers. There are no buttons. You cannot close this thing and keep it closed. So, you know, if your hands are full, you're doing something and there's a gust of wind or it's really cold outside, this is not necessarily a functional jacket for you to want to do anything out in harsher elements. Definitely more of a style piece for these mid-cold type of fall days that we are currently in. Not something you're going to take into the winter unless you're going to put it over another type of more warmer jacket, because even though this polyfill and everything might be decently insulating, it's just kind of left open on you, so it's not really gonna do its job. You do get two pieces of functionality with this jacket. You get a pocket on the inside, the left chest area, which is decently large. You can definitely throw like your phone in there. Most size smartphones should fit in there, your wallet, maybe keys. And then there are two bungee drawstrings on either side. And, you know, you see in the video, I'm cinching that and I can feel it kind of wrap more around my waist, but I'm skeptical as to how much that actually alters the silhouette on the outside of the jacket. I don't really see much of a difference, although it does kind of feel nice to feel a little bit of form on my waist to kind of, you know, feels like the jacket is just fitting better. And that was a nice touch. I think they could have probably just left it as is, and that might have led to this jacket feeling even just too unstructured and maybe just too wild. And because it lacks a zipper or buttons to kind of hold it closed across your front, that helps in just keeping it more like here and you know, you're never gonna get coverage here, but it's just, it kind of keeps you, gives you a little baby hug and gives it a little bit more form when you're walking and not having to hold that thing closed all the time. In a lot of ways, it's kind of just like an open cardigan, shawl collar, sweater. I'm getting this sense that it's just taking different pieces of inspiration from different types of garments, fusing it into one, stripping everything away, and giving it an exaggerated silhouette, something that you just haven't seen before, and now you have the round jacket from Yeezy Gap. Now, because the pre-sale is over, these things have already shipped out. These are technically sold out, so you're gonna be buying these things on the secondary market, so making returns is gonna be a problem. So I know there's a lot of people that are wondering about the fit on this. First of all, it's an oversized fit. That's what you're gonna get. It's already big as it is. I feel like the sleeves are even puffier and bulkier than the body of the jacket. So you're gonna look just big and round in this thing, kind of like, you know, Stay Puft Marshmallow vibe in this jacket. For me, because I knew it was an oversized fit, I figured anyway I would be okay with my kind of standard size for most outerwear brands, so I went with an extra large. I would usually get an extra large in a jacket from like Ralph Lauren or Nike, Adidas. You know, a lot of big brands, I'll probably just go with the XL and I'll be fine. But you tell me, comparing to the photos that we've seen of Kanye wearing this jacket to how you see me wearing it in this video, I feel like it looks more or less the same. So I think the XL was the right way to go for the desired look that they were going for with this jacket. Now, price point. This thing retailed for $200. Like we talked about earlier, pretty high for Gap, not crazy high for Yeezy clothing that we've seen in the past. Is this thing worth $200? I mean, how many things are truly worth the price points that they are sold at? This is definitely a subjective thing. You have to take your own personal finances into account and how much you're willing to spend on a piece of clothing to decide whether this is worth it. From a material standpoint, is it worth it? No, it's not. It's just blue nylon and polyester fill. It's not like it's a downfill, which is unethical anyway. And it's not like it's a leather shell. It's just, I don't know, it's not a high quality canvas. It really does feel like a cheap jacket. I have to say that. I don't really want to be that harsh because I know they're doing more than just making a jacket here, or they're at least trying to do more. I'm trying to be respectful of the creativity that is happening here. But the reality is, it's a blue nylon jacket with polyester fill. $200 is a lot of money, but they're getting it. And as far as resale goes, you can get it for about the same price. Like StockX right now, it's going for around that $200 price point. If you really wanna get this thing, you don't have to pay a crazy resale. I think it's worth it. If you want to own that first piece in the Yeezy by Gap collection, it's kind of like owning the first Yeezy colorway or owning pieces from the Yeezy Season 1 collection. You know, this could be a historical fashion artifact down the line. So maybe that's something that you want a piece of. You want a piece of that history. You don't care whether it really looks that good or not, but it does look kind of cool. I will say it is growing on me the more I wear it, and I'm still not sure how much I will wear it. I do think I might use it for a special occasion here or there. Overall, it's just kind of cool to have. It could be the kind of sea change that turns Gap around. You know, Gap has been struggling as a company. They are not really in the hearts and minds of the modern consumer when it comes to fashion. People are definitely moving in different directions, and Gap can't seem to hold on to consumers, especially the younger ones. Maybe with this Yeezy Gap collection, they can turn that around. And if that's all part of the story. So that's another cool thing. Either way, you're not getting hit hard on the resale with this color, at least. And the same goes for those hoodies that dropped as well. They're all going for around the retail price. And from what I've heard, the hoodies are pretty nice, comfortable. The quality and the construction, everything is definitely more on par with the price point as opposed to this. So that does it for me, guys, on this video, talking about this Yeezy Gap blue round jacket. You can kind of see I'm a little lukewarm on it. I'm warming up to it though, and I appreciate the art and the history and the kind of signifier that this jacket is. And I'm looking forward to hanging on to it and just kind of seeing where it sits in the lineage and the history of Kanye West as a fashion designer and just overall artist. And maybe it just will be not that big of a deal in 10, 15, 20 years. Who knows? Either way, it's definitely, I grew up with Kanye West, so it makes it a little bit more special for someone like me that was in high school for a college dropout going into college. The Kanye albums are like chapters in my life. So for me, as a Kanye fan, despite some of the things he does, this is pretty cool. And I'm happy to have taken part in it, and I have the piece now, and it can just kind of be part of my wardrobe and part of my collection. So overall, I'm happy. Now, if you are feeling this video, you've made it all the way to the end, consider joining the fam. I'm on the road to 10,000 subscribers, and I want you guys to be a part of it. On this channel, we talk sneakers, but we will also be talking more apparel. This is my first apparel review, and so I'm kind of working out the kinks, and we'll definitely get better, but I'm going to talk a little bit more about apparel and things, other things that are ancillary to the sneaker world, because we don't just wear sneakers. And I'm also including more full fit looks, more styles in my sneaker videos. So it's all coming together. And I like to talk more about clothes and fashion in general because I'm very much into that as well. So if you like all of those things, it sounds good to you, hit the follow. Check some of my helpful links down in the description below as well. Protective shoe spray and cleaning kits to keep your kicks clean. Some of my favorite sneaker books, as well as no links to cop this time, which like I usually say, because this thing, it's all secondary for this guy, but you can get it for a good price. Now, with all that being said, hope you have a good day, good evening, good night, whenever you're watching this, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace.